थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग फॉर टुडेज सेशन. हाय करिश्मा. हाय चिराग. हाय वी पटेल. हाय डीजे आर्टिस्ट. थैंक यू गाइज फॉर ज्वाइनिंग. आई थिंक टुडे वी गोइंग टू रिसीव सम अमेजिंग रिस्पॉन्स एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर सेंडिंग ऑल योर आर्ट वर्क. इट फील्स अमेजिंग दैट वी आर ट्राइंग टू डू समथिंग न्यू एंड ऑल ऑफ यू आर अप्रिशिएटिंग इट. इट्स रियली रियली ग्रेट टू यू नो सी सो मेनी डिफरेंट पीपल कमिंग टुगेदर एंड क्रिएटिंग an art form which is on the verge of dying and most of them don't even know about it. I'm so glad you're ready with your pen and markers. Hope you guys are too. So before starting, I will let you know what we are going to do today. So like the last session, we are again going to focus on Gondad. Gondad is one of the Adivasi style of painting. It's an old style of painting which people are not aware nowadays. Basically, these tribal artists, they use inspiration from the nature and create really very artistic forms of animals and plants and birds, basically elements from the nature. They use these elements to create something that's super colorful. It's not necessary to be very logical, very very specific. It's just very abstract, yet it is still inspired by the nature. If you go to see the motifs that is there on these drawings, I'll show you some that I've done. This one is my personal favorite. So I've used the element of snake and created a very unique art. It's still yet to complete, but this is what I've done. If you go to see the details, so mainly Gondad is all about these little details that they add after coloring, and all these paintings are super colorful. For all of you who are wondering and y'all don't have colors on you, do check this out. This is a black and white painting that I've done. I've just used two colors on it, that's pink and green, a little tinge of yellow as well. There's another painting that I've done. This is absolutely black and white. So everyone, if you guys do not have colors on you, y'all don't have your sketch pens or your paints or anything on you, just use black and white, and you can create the same kind of a look in black and white as well. You do not have to color it, just keep adding the details that I'll be showing you. This is the painting that we're going to do today. It's very simple but super intricate. Hi Shilpa, I think I cannot switch off the comment. You can do it from your end, from your phone. And if you have any questions, you can write it down. Later I'll be posting the video without the comments, so you can view it again and visualize what exactly we're doing. So let's call upon our guest for today. She is the founder of Tesora Designs. Tesora Design is mainly into accessories, into travel accessories. She makes passport holders, covers, diaries, planners, and I think after 2020 being the way it is, 2021, we all need a planner. So let's just wait for Saili Chaudhary to join us. So Ananya, you need is pen, paper, and pen, paper and sketch pens. I'll just show you the tools that we're going to use today. So these are the sketch pens that I'm using. It's very basic. You can use Faber Castell, that's what I normally use, but today because of the lockdown I don't have all my tools here. Hi honey. So I'm using this really basic sketch pen that I had at home. You can also use your watercolors if you guys are pretty good at it. I will also show you the sketch pens that I'll be using. So I'm using this marker. This is a sorry, this black gel pen. It's a basic black gel pen by Flair. You can use any black pen, even ball pen. The other pen that I'm using is by Cross. I think Siley is here. Let's. Siley. Hi Siley.
Hi Komal, how are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm good. I think there was some technical problem, which is why I could not send you a request, but I think we're here. Hi everybody. Hi Sakshi. Hi
Mohit.
Yes, I'm super excited and I'm super ready with all my tools here and paper. Yes.
So Siley, before we start, you tell me something about the Sora Designs.
So we at Sora Designs manufacture bags and travel accessories. We make all products in leatherite, in vegan leather. So basically everything that we make is manufactured and it's a completely made in India brand. All our products include passport wallets, luggage tags, keychains, planner diaries, and an array of products that y'all can also see on tesoradesigns.com.
Oh, that's amazing. And how are you dealing with the lockdown with all of this happening around?
So honestly, it's been quite a ride with all the lockdown and all the situation that's been through. But we've been working proactively on new designs, on newer products to introduce on our website for all our customers out there. And we've also been working on a lot of, you know, tie-ups with websites, etc.
Oh, super. Oh, so Siley, because right now we are here and we're going to start goal art. This is the drawing that we're doing. So, okay. So let's begin.
Let's begin. I'm super excited.
Super. So Siley, I will switch my camera. You can stay the way you are. And I will. You can ask me whatever questions you want in between. And let's have a good time.
Done. Let's start. Let's do this.
So guys, to begin with, like I always say, Kond is all about its natural elements and the natural details. We're going to start with the birds first. We're going to start with the birds first and then we will start doing the branches. And if you can go and see the details, this is the kind of detailing that we're going to do later. So let's start. To begin, make a C, and like we normally do a bird's body, do a very basic bird's body. You do not have to be super perfect, you just have to be very creative in filling it later on. We'll make two small beaks, one super tiny eye, and one we'll do like a neck band for it, and just for a decorative purpose we'll also add a tail band and something that's more like a wing. You can just add small dots in the neck band and small fine lines in the tail band. We'll also fill this portion with leaf structure. So it's all about the filling detailing. We'll continue doing more similar birds like this.
Oh wow, that's beautiful.
Siley.
This is the one that I've got.
Sally, it's okay if you do not show us what you're doing exactly. If you just want to interact, you can keep the camera to your face.
Okay. Hi, Loka.
And in between, I'll ask you to show me your drawing so we can. Hi, Preeti. Because you will have
Hi,
a lot of
Ojasvi.
viewers who will ask you some questions.
Okay, sure. I think that's a good idea.
So we'll
So how
continue
many
doing
birds
more
are we
drawings
looking at,
around.
Komal?
So it actually depends on your page size. I'm probably going to do a few. Say here I have around six, but today on my drawing I'm going to do around seven.
Okay, so your size, so my size of a paper is an A4, which would I think be a standard paper size for most of us.
So
What is an ideal size?
you can do say 7 to 8 birds.
Okay, 7 to 8 birds.
So we'll start doing the other side of the other birds. It's going to be exactly the same, but you can keep changing the direction of it just for good visual appeal. So again, we'll
Okay.
start with the C.
Hi Pooja, hi Aishwarya, hi Jyoti. Hi Ruchika. Recently joined, I would like to just go through something that Komal's already mentioned. She first drew a C, which is the mouth of the bird, and then from of the face of the bird, and from there she went on to draw the beak and then the body of the bird. Hi Felicia.
So like the way we did the first bird, we also did the second
Thank
bird. I think yours looks pretty cute, by the way.
Hi Anu.
So you'll have a lot of space around. So wherever you have space, you can change the sizes of the birds also.
Okay, so we have like adult birds and some baby birds, which I think will look good once we put it together.
Siley, tell me, what are
Guys,
you doing during the lockdown?
I have been drawing. I've been so it was always my hobby to draw, and I think I've been exploring more of that, and joining this session has been very exciting for me because it's helping me, work on something that I really love doing.
That's great,
What have you
and I
all been
think this
working
is
out
a
at Canvas?
So we're doing new designing stuff. I'm doing a lot of spreading the word of what the art is about and the different kinds of art we use at Canvas. It's always better if your audience knows what they're buying, and the way we create our own designs is nice to see people appreciate it. So that's what we're doing right now. And through
That's awesome.
amazingly talented entrepreneurs like you, we call upon someone each week, and it's a different experience to have guests over and understand they are part of the story.
So everything that I see at Canvas, all your prints that you've used in all the shoes, etc., everything's so, it has an Indian touch and they look so appealing and something so different from everything that we get outside. I definitely think that this is the way to go in the future.
Thank you, Sati. So, like you've seen, I'm already down on four of my birds. You tell me, Sati, how many have you done yet?
I finished 1.5. I'm going to finish this one in a bit and then I'm going to show you that one too. I'm almost done with my second board.
Superb. So you guys can continue drawing these birds. And later on, I'll tell you how to do the branches. So we'll again, these are authentic Gond art in interesting forms. So if you go to see, all of these art forms are very much inspired by the nature. You will see different kinds of elements of the nature on these paintings. These are almost 500 year old drawing style, but we have contemporized it. Earlier, Gond art was done with twigs and natural color, but now we use normal pens and colors because it's practically not possible, you know, to use the exact ancient style because of the durability of the product.
Okay. So do you design everything and do you draw everything that you manufacture at Canvas?
So most of it is my own painting. We also have tie-ups with different people, different NGOs from different regions that work with these tribal artists. Okay. So some of them, we get it done from them. Some of them, we do it at our own warehouse. And most of them are my own paintings, which are all inspired by Indian culture, Indian art. So none of these are, you know, like direct fabrics or copy paste, you know, normally the way people are doing it nowadays. We actually do each and every print from scratch.
I think all your designs speak for your brand, definitely.
Guys, your board needs to be like... Yes, Aili?
Hi Sneha, so the drawing style that we're doing right now is called Gond.
It's from rural Madhya Pradesh, originally from Madhya Pradesh.
So, okay, so I am 3 birds down. I'll just show you how they look. 1, 2, and 3.
Kali, you can also change the direction and, you know, just keep it crisscross. You can see the whole page.
Yours.
Superb. So you can now fill in more few birds in the center.
So guys, I would just like to ask you all, how many of you all are drawing with us? Just reply on me in the chat box and that would be great.
Sally, you can continue doing your birds. I will move on to the branches because okay. We are short on time. Or you can actually start with the branches and later, whenever you get time, you can finish your work. So to do the branches, just identify the empty spaces that's there around, you know, around your birds.
Okay.
So we'll start with this portion. So all your branches are going to be super wavy and, you know, there's no restriction when it comes to the shape. Just make sure, like branches, all your branches need to be thin, thick. You can make more variations so that they look super natural.
Okay. So we've got Cupcake Chidiya drawing with us, Krishna, Kari Desai, Utsarsha, Shweta, Jinal, Aishwarya, Supriya, and Smita. Wow, that's great. Nice. We would love to see your drawings when the session is over.
So like you can see, I'm trying to create as many branches in between. Just keep it very natural and draw more, you know, more lines.
Okay. I'm going to leave some space for birds, guys. And I think if y'all are not done with sufficient amount of birds, y'all can leave some spaces in your and your too.
I think Sally, I can call you again for more students just to, you know, guide the audience. Because sometimes I get so engrossed in my drawing, I forget that I'm actually, you know, doing it for everybody.
Hi, Komal. Hi, Mistry. I think Mistry is also drawing with us. That's great.
It's nice to, you know, see people trying to attempt something that you love. So I've already given, you know, support to the birds here. I'll also draw some fine branches around this area.
Hi, Kim.
And we'll take it down, continue it downwards.
So I'm going to start with the branches too.
Guys, you don't have to be very specific. Just keep going with the flow.
Guys, I was really skeptical to draw the branches at first. I've just started drawing the branches, as you all can see. As I drew the branches, I just realized once we draw the branches, we'll have sufficient space to fill in more words. So don't worry about that.
I think I have more birds outside my window also.
Yeah, I can do it. I can do it.
Posters just make tiny feet for your birdies. It's basically a line and a V. So these art forms are not very complicated, so that's the best part, that anybody can do it. It's all about, but it requires a lot of patience. So yeah, that's all you need. You need not be good at drawing, but you need patience.
Hi Dhriti. Hi Soumya. Hi Smita. Yes, she can hear the sound of birds. That is from Komal's house.
So like you all can see, yeah. I'm already done with most of my branches. I can still find some space here, but we'll not fill it right now, depending on, you know, the detailings that we add later. If we think that we have more space, we can add more branches later.
I'll just show you my drawing, Komal. Look at, have a look at this. So I'm done with 3 full birds and I just have a stencil of 2 of them, but I started with the branches.
I think, Siley, you're doing an amazing job. And I don't know why were you so skeptical about drawing, but I think for everybody who is, you know, trying to draw with pens directly and you cannot do it, you can start with pencils. Just, you know, marking what you want to do, where you want to do the placements. Like, suppose in my drawing, if I want to know that, hey, this space I'm going to leave for the branches, I'm just going to, like, you know, just... make these small lines, if you can see. And then you can do it directly with your pens. For everyone who has joined lately, you can use any gel pen. I am using a basic gel pen by Flair. This is what I normally use. But I also have this super pen by Cross. So this is what I'm using right now. It's much more thicker than your general gel pen.
Guys, I'm using an Uniball eye, so I think most of us have this at home. And yeah, it's doing a pretty good job.
That works amazingly well. Thanks, Swati.
Here, Dhriti, here's my drawing for you. Oh, Smita says maybe they're trying to see how the words. So sweet. Hi, Soumya.
So, just to continue this, because we're doing a very abstract version of elements from the nature. We'll start doing the leaves also, but we're not planning to do the basic leaves. What we'll do is wherever you feel you have space, all you have to do is draw a bigger circle. Sally, do you want me to wait for you?
Yeah, no, 1 second. What did you just start doing? Sorry. So wherever there's space, you draw a bigger circle, right?
Bigger circle. So okay. That's what we have to fill for our leaves.
Okay. So I'm guys, for everybody who's on the same page as I am, I'm just going to draw a small C for wherever I want to place my bird. So I know that I'm going to draw a bird here. And I'm done with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and a little bird here that I want to draw. Okay, so I'm going to draw the circle
so
now.
Like I did the circle here, I also okay. want to do a semicircle. Yes, Driti, you can also use a black basic ball pen. That works too. So I'll do a semicircle here. So I have a smaller page.
Okay, so this is my circle. So are we drawing circles around every bird that we have?
No, so we're not doing it around the bird. Basically, these are for a more, representation for bushes, like okay. a tree bushes. So we'll okay. do it more around the branches, if you can see here.
Oh, okay, got it.
And then we're going to do these leaf patterns inside.
Okay.
So this is comparatively a little, complicated drawings than the one we've done. So I have chosen this for you because you are already good at it.
Okay. I hope I'm good at this one. So, you know, what I've done here is because I thought we drew a circle around every bird.
That's
I drew
okay.
a bird here. Yeah. And then I drew a makeshift branches behind it. So that,
that's
yeah.
fine. That's fine. You know, the representation can be the way you like it because there is no restriction. When it comes to these art forms, there is no restriction, no specification. You can just do whatever you like.
Okay. Hi, Dhara. I think, Driti, yes, you can use a black ball pen. I think Komal's answered that already.
And your circle also need not be like super specific circle. We'll just not cross the branches. Just try not drawing on the branches, just around it, behind the birds. And this is basically your background.
Okay.
So I'm doing more of these circles around my birds, around my branches, wherever I have space. So I think, Sally, if you do not want to do more birds for now, so you can just drop the idea. You can also do these circles.
Okay.
And yes, just I'm make sure you're doing different sizes of okay. circles.
Yes, so they look.
Thank you, Dhara. Thank you, Supriya. Soumya, this art is mainly from Madhya Pradesh. The tribe that used to actually do this is called Gond, and the art is also called Gond. If you want to know more, you can also Google it up or check out our website. So like you can see, already done a lot of circles. But I still want to do more branches. So I think like Sally started doing the branches later on, I'll also do a few here. Just maintain the connectivity from, one part to another. It looks nicer. There's nothing ever going to go wrong with an art form like this because it's super abstract. If you have any issues you're facing while drawing, please message us. Yes, Ananya, we're going to repost this post so you can have a look. We are also going to put it up on our IGTV so you can check them out later.
Hi, Dipali. So Dipali is actually a part of Tessara Designs too, and I'm really glad to see her here.
Hi, Dipali. Nice to see you. Hope you're doing well. So if you guys want to really see how we use these art forms on our shoes, you can check our website. There is like a brief detail about which art form is used on which shoe. I'm just finding
Hi, Rucha.
It's way too big for the brand, so I've added like a spacing. So my basic drawing is done. My whole page is full. I'm still going to wait for Siley to get done with the circles and the branches.
Hi, Rucha. So Rucha is also my sister and helps us immensely at Tessara. And I think she's drawing with us too.
I hope Rucha is also drawing.
Yes, she is. So Soumya is asking us what colors can be used. Soumya, I think you can use anything from sketch pens to your...
So you can use your pencil colors, sketch pens, your basic... So this is what I am using. You can use any basic sketch pen as well. You can use watercolors if you're super good at it. Yes, Jinal, if it's okay if you don't do a lot of colors, you can do some. I had a lot of space, so I actually did a lot of circles, but you can just do few. So let's move to my favorite part of drawing, and that's coloring. Siley, are you ready?
I want to see your drawing once. Where are you at? Okay. So this is where I am, and... do you have any suggestions of where I can draw a circle or maybe an extra board?
On your left hand side top corner, you can
this
do
one?
Like a half circle. Yeah, no, but on more top.
Okay, like here.
Yeah. You can do a circle there.
Okay.
And I think you can do one more circle in between on the cross of the bigger branches right in
this
the
one.
Center. A little.
Yeah,
left.
Yeah. Your, right?
Yeah. Just do like a circle there. So I think then you'll be done. Baki, don't do more branches or anything. If you feel later on, you can add that later also.
Yeah, I like those, those thin, tiny branches like you have on your drawing. I think they look really nice.
Yeah, just do these wherever you feel you have extra space. But these, we'll do it later also because that depends on, you know, after the drawing is done, if you feel there is more space. So okay. Guys, let's move on to coloring. You need basic two colors for now. Firstly, we're just going to color the birds. I'm going to use a yellow color. And an orange color. So these are the two colors that I'm using. Vermilion is more towards your red. So this is a darker orange, I would say. So some birds I'm going to color yellow, some I'm going to color orange.
Hi, Prathamesh. Hi, Mithin. Hi, Sneha.
So I'll start coloring the birds.
So like Komal's also suggested, I've drawn a circle here, a tiny bird in here. And then I think I'm just going to fill in the branches. But I think I will move towards coloring with her. And these are the sketch colors that I have. This one.
There's no color variation. Just avoid coloring the band. The more detailed coloring you do, I mean, it's not in terms of adding too many colors, but, you know, just keeping that little white section. I forgot to do the design here, so I'm just doing it.
Guys, we're open to any questions that you have at all. Please post them in the comments.
and we
hi,
do more
Neera,
than
hi, Prathmesh.
Okay, I've colored my first board. Okay, so you're using orange, reds, and yellows to draw the color the birds,
I'm
right?
I'm just using orange and yellow.
Okay, so okay, that looks like a red, but guys, that is a yellow. Oh, sorry, that's an orange.
It's a darker orange, but it's not red.
She draws quite often. I think she has a lot of colors, but guys, these are the colors that I have. And these work perfectly as well.
I use basic colors like yellow, green, blue, you know, something that's available with everyone. Mainly these paintings have really basic primary colors.
Also, I think all these brighter colors make a painting look very preppy, nice and fun to look at.
And that's what Gondat is also about. If you see, either they use like a fully pastel shade or they keep it super, super, super bright.
I'm on to coloring my second board.
So I've done three yellow birds and I'm going to do three orange birds.
Guys, Komal is super skilled at this. She is comparatively fast. Even me might be newer, but that's totally okay.
Thank you, Sneha. Thank you so much. Now I'm moving to coloring my orange bird. So Sonia is asking us, should we color the full bird in one color or the design, the wings can be different? It's better you color with one color because we're going to add a lot of colors in the background.
Yes, Prathamesh, please share your doubt. Okay, so I'm not done with the beak of this little bird. I think I'm going to do that first. It's going to look extremely odd.
All you guys who are drawing with us, if you have any doubts or you all think that I should go a little slower, please let me know. I'm also going to post this on IGTV and on my feeds post the session. You all can go back and view it again. So I'm here done with coloring my birds.
Okay, I'm done with coloring about three birds right now, but I think that's good.
Till then, I'll also show you a detail. This detail is super intricate, so you will definitely not finish it today, right now in the session. So I'm just going to show you a part of the detailing and y'all can do it later. So the detailing is actually these branches. This painting I've actually colored a castle. Right now I'm using these different colors which are much more brighter.
Okay, wow, that looks great.
This is the branch detail that we're going to do right now. It's super intricate and it takes a lot of time. So all I will tell you is just do a small part with me right now. Later you can finish the others. So let's
start.
Kylie, if you have any doubts, you can please ask me.
No, I will once we get to drawing the branches.
So just to do the detailing, Sally, I think you can do this with me so that you can see it properly once.
Okay.
What we're doing here, I will use a thinner pen, which is your normal ball pen, because mine is a little thicker. So I'll actually use the normal one. You can use what you're using right now, Sally. All you have to do is make smaller lines inside your branches.
So more thinner and more intricate.
Yeah, and the way you have the fine details on the wood, normally your natural wood has these lines. You just have to keep doing those. Avoid drawing on the bird. Do not draw on the bird. So if you think a bird is coming in between, just avoid it by drawing around it. So like you can see, the way you have the wood effect on normal wood, that's what we are doing here.
So basically there's no pattern, but it's more free-flowing, but it has hints and textures of how wood should be.
And I would want you to fill it as much as you can.
Wow, that looks really good.
The best part of this drawing is that it's not very difficult to do. It just requires patience. And after you finish it, it looks like one big masterpiece. Just free flow your hand, draw whatever you like.
Basically, there's nothing right, there's nothing wrong. It's just supposed to look very natural. Thank you, Hemi Oshad. Yes, we'll be keeping our exhibition, Hemi Oshad, very soon. I think once this lockdown is over and things are better. Meanwhile, you get for Canvas, you can shop on their website, and for Tesara, you can visit us.
So like you can see right now, I've already done this. I think, Saili, that's perfect. That's exactly how you have to do. Just keep doing these fine lines around. And after you are done with doing these lines, now we'll be adding these smaller details inside. These are nothing but coloring the alternate details. Can you guys see my screen clearly?
Yeah, it looks beautiful.
So, Saili, now I think you can also see this. So, we'll be coloring. Just take your. You can also use a marker.
Yeah, I think I'm going to use my sketch pen for this one, which I think will give a thicker and a faster and easier. I think
I'm
this looks
good.
I'm
making smaller squares inside those lines. But use the alternate panels, huh?
Okay.
So you can start with one side of your branch and going to another.
Yes, a sketch pen really makes this much easier and smoother to do.
I'll also show you the effect of the sketch pen. I have a black. This is much more easier. It's just one dot and you're done.
Yeah, exactly. Hi, Meera. Thank you. Thank you so much, Prathamesh. He thinks he did not know that this can be so easy, while it looks so integrated. I'm glad.
I think a lot of people are drawing with us, and it makes me just feel so nice.
I think when we started off in the earlier session, we had a lot of people saying that they are drawing with us. And I think the numbers actually increased.
Now I want to see everyone's drawing. Guys, please tag us the canvas for us to see what you're doing.
Guys, if you all have any doubts, please ask.
You're going to put this video up on our IGTV later for everyone who wants to do this slowly and wants to look it up again. You can see how intricate this is. So these are actually the original paintings that we use on our shows. So each art takes like hours and hours to create, and then we eventually transfer it to the shoe. I think once the lockdown is done, I'll actually show the shoe. Now all of our shoes are in our office, so we can practically not show you guys the shoes.
I would actually love to see it. And I can totally imagine how much time each of your shoe takes to design.
Thank you, Ojasri. Thank you so much. Y'all can check canvas.world to see the shoes and the designs. If you want to know which shoe has a particular print, we'll always share the links. Just DM us.
So what are we going to draw next? What are we going to color next, Komal?
This is exactly what your branch is going to be about. Like all of this, and this is okay. Going to be this. So you can imagine how much intricate details we're going to add. But because you know, we're not going to do all of this right now.
Yeah, we're pressing for time.
This is how it's going to be. So let's move on to do the circles. Sally, your bird is very cute, by the way.
Thank you so much.
So I'm moving to do the circles.
Okay, I'm coming to after I finish this coloring.
I'm going to just do one color today for this circle. It's a very light shade of blue.
Okay, so we all of us need like a light shade of blue. So everybody who doesn't have color sketch pens or color pencils, etc., even a black and white image of how you do this is something that we'd like to see.
You can also just use your basic pencil to do a little shading inside. That also looks pretty nice. So I'm using a blue that I have. This is still a little darker than what I normally would use, but that's okay because that's what I have right now.
I have two blues and this is what I'm going to pick.
I am coloring the center circle first.
I think I'm going to take this one. Okay, so we just color it all blue.
Komal? So Smita, this takes about 5 to 6 hours to finish. Sometimes we take more time depending on the detailing. When I actually draw for my shoes in specific, our designs are more intricate. So it takes like 12 hours, but I normally don't do it at a stretch. Like around 8 to 12 hours is what we take to finish one intricate design, and something that I'm doing right now, this would take me around 6-7 hours. My blue is a little different. This is more like an aqua blue. You guys can use the blue that you have. I don't have like a super light blue right now with me.
I think mine is also more like an aqua blue. Also, because my tip is not very thick, I have shades of blue within the blue itself.
But that's okay. That still adds in the detailing. It looks more raw also.
I'm so going to as a designer, do you usually use like sketch pens and pen pencils, or do you prefer using watercolors to make your artwork?
Like I said, it all depends on what I'm doing. Something like this, I would prefer doing the basic paint with watercolor, the basic coloring. So, Rupal, I'm using a basic cartridge paper. This is exactly what you have in your drawing paper on your drawing books. I just have a smaller book, but you can use your normal cartridge paper also.
Yeah, the one that I'm using is a normal cartridge paper, size paper.
Your drawing book paper works, your chart paper also works. Anything that's a little thicker so that your colors don't come on the opposite side. Like mine, these will still come on the opposite side, but if you use a very thin paper, it really seeps in.
Okay, so I'm almost done with my blue. Once you're done with this, what is the next step, Komal? What do we look at doing?
So after your circles are done, let me just finish mine so I can show you what you can do.
Okay, I want to see yours too.
Okay, guys, if you feel your colors are seeping in, you can always put another page in between two of your drawings. Like I've done here, you can put a page in between so that your drawing behind this does not get spoiled.
Okay, my blue looks a little more raw, I think probably because I'm using just normal, regular sketch pens.
You can also use watercolor, your pencil colors. And nowadays you get these soluble pencil colors, which are equally fun. So you can, you know, just use the pencil colors and then use water on it and just spread it. Mine actually looks more green.
Yeah, yours looks more green, but it looks more finished. I think that's also because maybe the tip of your sketch pens. Yeah, marker. Because if you look at mine,
more like a paintbrush feel.
Yeah, if I zoom out, this is how it looks, but a little zoomed in and you can see the patches, but I think that's nice.
That also adds a very nice rough feel to it. So guys, after you are done with this, we'll again go back to our black pen and adding detailing to our circle. So we're going to do small leaves inside. So I'll just show you some of the detailing that I've done.
Guys, I've got some more sketch pens.
If you can see, I've
thank
done
you, Marisha. Three thank you, Sagar.
In my circle.
Okay.
One is the leaf pattern. The other one is the circular pattern. And the third one is the line one. But today, we're just doing the leaf pattern.
So that basically goes into our circle, right? The circle that we've already colored in?
Yes. If your color is light and you have a darker color pen, you can also do color on color. I'm just doing with my black pen because that's what I have here. Can you see, Siley?
Yeah, I can see. I'm just trying out if I use a... Okay, I also have a navy blue. Do you think I should try a navy blue on this one?
If your blue is lighter, then try a navy blue. Otherwise, you can stick to the black.
Okay, this is one leaf that I've drawn. You might want to look. No,
You can stick with the black. Because
yeah, I think I'm going to stick with the black.
Then you can use a navy blue.
Besides, I think when I'm using the blue sketch pen, it's pretty. So when you draw the leaves, are you overlapping each leaf onto another, or are you drawing it at a very random space?
I'm just drawing very randomly, but you can overlap, you can do as you're comfortable with. I'm just drawing leaves wherever I have space. Just do not draw over your birds or your branches. The direction does not matter. Even nothing actually matters. Just keep drawing as many leaves as you can. So that's, I'm done with one circle. I'm going to do the other one right now. So for everyone who's thinking that, hey, I am too fast to finish this, but guys, I'm going to post this video later on my feed as well as on our IGTV. So you all can check it out later as well.
If anybody feels she is very fast, I am with you guys. But I think let her complete and then all of us can do it at our own pace.
I hope you're enjoying this.
I am. I really am.
So this works as a therapeutic session also. I mean, you feel very relaxed after, you know, doing these repetitive circles and designs, and it's more like meditation also for some people.
It definitely is, because, I mean, see, there's nothing right and there's nothing wrong, and I think it's just letting your creativity flow.
Guys, you can actually check products with these paintings and prints on canvas.world. So I'm almost done with mine. So all of this takes a lot of time, like really takes a lot of time. Finally, I think we are short on time.
I'm just going to show you whatever I'm done with.
Sally, we just have 47 seconds, so I think we can wrap this up because we just have 1 hour of session that we can do. So guys, just to conclude, this is what I've done for now. And you guys can always watch the whole session yourself online later on our feed and on our Instagram IGTV. This is the total output. I've done too many circles, but you can just do one. Thank you so much for joining, and love you guys. And please share your pictures and tag us. Thank you, Siley, for coming in.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me. Oh, this is my drawing, and yeah, it was me. I'll send you the complete drawing for sure. It was great having you guys. Thank you. Bye.